manage, and a lot of, we get a lot of people asking, how do you manage motherhood and being an author? How do you, like, say, okay, this time I and, you know, managing your kids' classes and back from school and homework and all of that?
Yeah, it's not easy. I don't think it ever gets completely easy. It's not like being able to go to a workplace and switching off and making everything and someone else's problem and then coming back at the end of the day and being happy to see them because you haven't seen them all day. So, no, it's not that easy. Sometimes even I wish I had a horrid school that I could ship them off to for a few hours and forget about them. But having said that, you know, in my previous interviews when Visha Was a Writer was published, someone had asked me, how do you write? It then ended up being the headline of that review because I said I write in confusion and crisis. But I think a little of that has changed because kids, and this is the most wonderful thing about having them, is that they get older.
Yes.
And as they get older, yeah, they're not as much work as they were when they were younger.
Yeah.
I also think that when you decide to do something new in your life and you make a change in your life, you create changes in the lives of people around you. They don't always like the change, like who moved my cheese.
Yeah.
So basically, when I first decided I wanted to write, my kids couldn't handle the fact that I suddenly had something else to do besides being
true,
with them.
True.
And especially when they were around, they didn't like the fact that I was on a computer typing or that I wanted to be alone.
They didn't want to share mommy.
They didn't want to share mommy with her stories. But over time, when they saw how much I wanted this, when they see how it makes me, also having grown a little older and become more reasonable human being, I think that now they're able to understand that even when they're home, that sometimes I'm preoccupied or I'm in the middle of a chapter, they've come home and you know what, I just can't let go of it. So I ask for an hour more and then they give me that hour more, they make themselves scarce, they're quiet or not so quiet as the day might proceed,
okay,
but they're able to allow me that.
So there's hope for all of us moms whose kids are much younger and we're aspiring to work and we're little that our kids will...
Well, three things I would say there. One is give it time, because kids do grow up. And that's the great thing about having them, like I said. So be patient, give it time, let things take their own course. The second thing is do what you need to do to be happy. Because I think you're happy as a mother. And your kids will sense that you're a much happier, more fun person to be around.
Right.
You know? And thirdly, when you're working, work. Don't spend that time being on the phone or doing anything else. So when they're out of the house, my time begins, my clock begins, and that is what I do till they get home. But then once they get home, most of the time, I'm able to say, fine, I've done my deal for the day, and now I'm with you. And then there's no guilt, you know, because you work when you work and you play when you play.